DM Science and Plants World presents about the racemose inflorescence based on the main axis flat tender. Here, the inflorescence is defined as the group of flowers that arise from branched or unbranched axis with definite pattern. As definition says, you can find the inflorescence of Nerium plant in the picture. The inflorescences are categorized into four types. First one is racemose, which is an indeterminate growth. Next one is cymose, it is a determinate growth. Next one is mixed inflorescence, which contains both the racemose and cymose inflorescence. Next one is the specialized inflorescence, which doesn't follow the pattern of racemose and cymose and mixed inflorescence. In this video, as I said before, we are going to see about the racemose inflorescence, particularly based on the flat-ended main axis. Racemose has the central axis that is called a peduncle, which possesses the terminal bud, which has the capacity or capability to grow continuously and produces the lateral flowers, and that is called as racemose inflorescence. Here, the olden flowers are arranged at the base of peduncle, that is central axis of inflorescence, and the younger flowers and buds are placed towards the apex of the inflorescence. Here, the main axis of an inflorescence is mostly flat-ended, that is convex or concave. Convex is the shape that the presence of bend towards the outside, and in case of concave, the bend or protrude faces the inward, or it may be globose. A head or capitulum is in a determinate or in indeterminate way. It follows either determinate or indeterminate growth. Group of sessile, that is the flowers that lacks the stack that hold the flower, it is called as pedicel, or subsessile flowers arising on a receptacle, often subtended by an involucre. Here in this picture you could find the small leaflet like structures that holds the petals of the flower, that is called as involucre. The whole structure is defined as an involucre. Individually it is called as bract. As I said, the flower or inflorescence are subtended by a lateral appendages that resembles the leaf like structure is called as bract. Here in the sunflower you could find the green leaf like structure, that is called as bract. Here in sunflower, the whorl of bract forms a cup like structure that mimic like a calyx. Here the bract combine together and forms a circle and forms a cup like structure that mimics like a calyx, but it is a bract. And this kind of arrangement of bract is called as involucre. Here a group of bract that present beneath the subunit of inflorescence is called as involucelle. Here this whole picture is called as a single inflorescence. Peduncle has the many secondary peduncle. From a common point you could find the origination of many secondary peduncle, that is the subunit of inflorescence, where the red arrow mark indicates the involucelle. Next one is the head. Here the head inflorescence is the character features of the family Asteraceae, Rubiaceae, Fabiaceae, and this is the example of head inflorescence, Mimosa pudica. It is commonly known as touch sensitive plant. Torus. Torus is the portion which holds the gynoecium, that is the female part of the reproductive system, which present in the flower. The torus contains two types of florets. First one is disc florets. It may be also called as tubular florets. Next one is the ray floret. It also called as lingulate floret. Head inflorescence is classified into two types. First one is the homogamous head and next one is the heterogamous head. Here in homogamous head, the inflorescence exhibit single kind of floret. Either it may be disc floret or ray floret. Example for disc floret is Vernonia and the example for ray floret is Lanonia. So this is the flower of Lanonia, where you can find the ray floret arrangement. And next one is the heterogamous head. In this inflorescence, it contains both types of florets, that is disc and ray florets. Example for heterogamous head is Tridax procumbens. In this picture you could find the Tridax flowers, where you can find the ray and disc florets. At the center point where it is yellow in color, you could find the disc florets, which is tubular and contains the bisexual flowers. And the lateral side, that is white color, which is present in the margin of flower, is the ray florets, which is lingulate, pistillate and unisexual. So this is about the racemose inflorescence based on main axis flattened head. Thank you so much for watching.